Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the John Singleton Field here at Porter Gow School. Cyclone fans, come on down and form the tunnel. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is homecoming here at Porter Gowd, and we'd like to extend a special welcome to all of our alumni who are here tonight. It's also the day for PG. It's the day for PG here at Porter Gowd. This is the day where our school family comes together to celebrate being a Cyclone and show our belief in the Porter Gowd experience. Please join me, our faculty and staff, and our board of trustees with a gift to the Cyclone Fund. In the event of inclement weather, we've installed the ThorGuard lightning prediction system. This system can provide advance warning of a lightning hazard, allowing you the time to seek shelter. The alert is a loud horn blast lasting 15 seconds. If you hear this warning, please clear the field and the stands and seek appropriate shelter, preferably in the Wendell Center Gymnasium or in your car. The Tansburg Pavilion is not considered safe shelter from lightning. When the system indicates that a threat has passed, school personnel will announce that in the parking lot and the Wendell Center, and the horn will sound 3 5-second all clear blasts. Both Porter Gowd and Lawrence Manning are proud members of the South Carolina Independent School Association. Tonight's contest is being played according to the rules and regulations of both SCISA and the National Federation of High Schools. We remind all spectators that even though this game is competitive, it's also an educational experience for all players and students. High school athletics emphasizes positive values. Everyone present is encouraged to take personal responsibility for exhibiting good sportsmanship and positively supporting his or her team, and is asked to support the decisions made by coaches and officials tonight. Tonight's officials are impartial and have been licensed by the South Carolina Independent Schools Athletic Association. Let me remind all of our fans, both home and visitors, that Porter Gowd is a smoke-free campus, and that includes e-cigarettes. The entire area inside the fence, both the track and all grassy areas, are off limits to all fans during play. And fans are reminded that no Porter Gowd students are ever allowed on the visitor side of the field, on the tennis courts, or in any area south of the scoreboard and flagpole at any time. We'd like to extend a special thanks to Brett Davis and his outstanding ground staff, Terrell Burns, Bill Blessington, Brendan Duddy, and Tim Neely, for making John Singleton Field one of the area's premier high school football facilities. Let's give them a great big hand. Let's also make sure and show our appreciation for all their hard work by using the proper receptacles around the stadium for our trash. Each week, the Cyclone player who best demonstrates the qualities of perseverance, grit, character, love for team, and quiet leadership will don the number 9 jersey, which symbolizes the faith, love, and overcoming spirit of Charleston's Emmanuel 9. Wearing number 9 tonight, Baker Lamberson. At this time, if you will, please rise, face the flag, and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem. Thank you. And please remain standing for the invocation, delivered tonight by DeBose Eggleston, Border Guide Head of School and Class of 93 alumnus.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful evening, for the ability to gather here together, and for the gifts of sport and competition. We ask for your blessing over this game, that you would protect the players from both our schools, help them to perform to the best of their ability, and that we would all honor and glorify you in our thoughts, words, and deeds. We also thank you for the presence of family, friends, and alumni, and for their innumerable contributions to the life of our school. May you give us the grace and faithfully stand upon their shoulders. Bless our fellowship with your presence and give us thankful hearts for all your many blessings. For it is in your most holy name we pray, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
All right, Cyclone fans, come on down and form that tunnel as the captains are about ready to take the field. Captain's taking the field. For Lawrence Manning, captains number 14, Bryson Smith, number 11, Thomas Sumter, number 9, Chapel Brogdon, and number 12, Josiah Person. Cyclone Captain's Knight, number 1, Tony Brown, number 30, James Ball, and number 77, Jaser Amer. So as we start the game, Lawrence Manning will receive.
Stay focused on the pass, please. Look at what's in front of you. 7-1-1 matchup. Keep yours. Do your job. Do your job.
Thank you.
Fielded by Noah Tanner. Out near the 23-yard line. And that's where Lawrence Manning will take over, first and 10. Flag on the play. False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. It'll bring up first and 15. Replay to down. Handoff goes to Bryson Smith. Out to the 35-yard line. That'll be enough to move the chains. First and 10. Bryson Smith, the ball carrier again. Gain of 5. Second and 5. Short, third and a short one. Bryson Smith gets the carry again and he picks up the first down. Yeah. Handoff goes number 11, Thomas Sumter. He'll pick up another Lawrence Manning first down. First and 10. Ball spotted at the 37-yard line. Handoff goes to Hartley Bickerstaff. Gain of a couple. Second and 8. Keeper by Tony Brown across the 40. Cyclones face 3rd and 5. Bickerstaff on the carry. Short of the yard to gain. It'll be 4th and 2. Cyclone punt unit will come on. Langdon Chevis on to punt for the Cyclones. Number 11, Thomas Sumter back to receive. Punts down to back of the 25-yard line, and that's where the Swamp Cats will get it back, 1st and 10. Make sure and visit the Porter Gow Parent Association fill-in station concession stand. Hot dogs, hamburgers, Jimmy Haygood's famous barbecue. Best food in Skeezer right here at Singleton Field. Lane Bowen with the carry. Spotted at the 35-yard line, and that's good for a first down. Number 14, Bryson Smith, picks up another swamp cat first down at midfield. Ian Harris, number 5, gets the carry. And he'll pick up 5 more. It'll be 2nd and 5. Ball spotted at the 44. Falls in, complete. Intended for Bryson Smith. Brings up 3rd and 5. I believe that was Baker Lamberson wearing the number 9 jersey on the coverage. Quarterback keeper for Tyler June. He'll move the sticks. Swampcats first down. When you do hit the Parent Association concession stand, make sure and thank them for the outstanding new programs we have this year. For the Cyclotron Video Scoreboard and the new Wendell Center Scorers Table. Thanks also to our advertisers. Your support of the Parent Association directly supports Cyclone Athletics. Tyler June's pass, complete off number 3, Jackson Brunson. Exactly 10 yards, and that'll move the chains. Ian Harris on the carry. He'll get 3. It'll be 2nd and 7. Pass complete down to the 10-yard line. That'll be enough for a first down. Just short of the 10. So the chains will stay out there. 1st and 10 at, we'll call it the 11. Bryson Smith on the carry. Not much happening there. Loss of a couple on the play. 2nd and 12. June on the keeper. Swallowed up by the Cyclones D-line. Senior Jaser Amer, first guy to get him. Swamcats, third and 11. Student section this morning brought a home crowd, right? Make a little noise. June's pass is complete, but there is a yellow hanky on the field. The two is holding, so we'll mark that off against the offense. That takes the Swamcats all the way back to the 26-yard line. Third in the country mile. Make some noise, Cyclone fans. That's what you're here for on homecoming night. Fourth and a mile. Four down territory for the Swamcats. Fourth and about 26. Back to throw. And broken up by Tony Brown. Cyclones will take over on downs. Dark side defense getting the job done. Cyclone offense back on the field. First and 10 at the 25-yard line. Hartley Bickerstaff rumbles forward for about four. Second and 6 for the Cyclones. Bishop incomplete. Brings up third down. Pitch can settle. He'll get a few, but not enough. It'll be 4th and 5. And we'll see the punt team again for the Cyclones. Langdon Chavis will come on. Once again, Thomas Sumter will drop back. And the Clones will let the clock run out here on this first quarter with our score still 9-0. As we change into the field, let me remind you of the results this week. On Monday and Tuesday of this week, our girls golf team headed to Orangeburg for the Skeezah State Championships, where they had a great day and finished as Skeezah State runner-up. First trophy in the case of the new year. On Tuesday, girls tennis defeated Somerville on senior night. The tennis fell at Ashley Hall, while middle school football won at Northwood. And last night, varsity volleyball lost at home versus Ashley Ridge. Coming up this week, tomorrow morning, we're going to host a middle school cross-country invitational as well as our JV volleyball invitational right here on campus. Monday afternoon, volleyball travels to Ashley Hall. Tuesday, volleyball goes to Pinewood, while tennis hosts Cardinal Newman right here at Singleton Field in the first round of the Skeezah State Playoffs. Wind balls at home for senior night versus Oceanside. And if playoffs go well, we'll see both tennis and swim finals for Skeezah are this coming Saturday. Tennis in Sumter and swim at the North Charleston Aquatic Center. Second quarter action underway. Cyclones on to punt. Langdon Chavis puts his foot into it. Thomas Sumter back deep. Punt takes a great Cyclone roll and will be down at the 26-yard line. And that is where the Swamp Cats will get it back, 1st and 10. Swampcats 1st and 10 from the 26. Hand off goes to Bryson Smith. Flag comes in. Face mask against the Cyclones. We'll add on to that play. It was a face mask of the 5-yard variety. He didn't mean to do that. It was an accident. Replay, 1st down, 1st and 5. Swing pass goes out to Thomas Sumter, and he'll get across the 40. Lawrence Manning, 1st down. Pass is out Jackson Brunson. He'll get across midfield and another 1st down. Correction, not a 1st down. 2nd and 1. Ball spotted at the 49. Thomas Sumter gets the carry. First and 10 at the 44. That brings up second and 10. Sumter, the ball carrier. Gain of just a couple. It'll be third down and 8. Make some noise, Cyclones. It's a possession down. Third and 8. Third and 7. Stays on the field for the Swampcats. Quarterback keeper for Tyler June, and he goes a long way. Picks up a first down. First and 10 Swampcats down at the 15-yard line. Pass complete to Lane Bowen. Loss of a yard or two on the play. Second down and 12. Smith, the ball carrier. Senior Chaser Amber says, no, sir. Tackle for loss, third and long. Once again, a fourth down attempt for the Swampcats. And passes it to number three, Jackson Brunson is in complete. And once again, the Cyclones take a rundown. And check out the PGPA concession stand over the next few minutes, because you'll definitely want to be in your seats for halftime on this homecoming night. John Settle on the carry. Gain of 7, 2nd and 3. Bickerstaff on the carry, tripped up right at the line of scrimmage. 3rd down. John Settle on the carry, and he'll get it to the sticks for a Cyclone 1st down. Settle on the carry. He'll get 3, 2nd and 7. Bickerstaff on the carry, and he'll rumble down to the 35-yard line. Big Cyclone 1st down. Tony Brown on the keeper. Brought down for loss of a yard, 2nd and 11.
Hey, yo, I'm making a change today to make a
Ball pops loose, and the Swamp Cats recover at the 35-yard line. And they'll get it back first and 10 with 3.5 minutes remaining in the half. Keeper for June. He gets 4. James Ball brings him down. 2nd and 6. Quarterback keeping for Tyler June escapes a tackle and picks up a first down. For the sack. Second and about 13. Handoff goes to Bryson Smith. He'll get a few. It'll be 3rd and 8. Pitch goes to number 3, Jackson Brunson. A lot of horizontal, but not a lot of vertical there. It'll be 4th down. Cats will kill some clock and talk it over. As we come up on halftime, ladies and gentlemen, I encourage you to keep your seats and enjoy the festivities on this homecoming night. intercepted. James Ball. And Cyclones will get it back with 12.4 seconds remaining in the half. Bickerstaff with a handoff, and that'll be last play of the half. Knotted up still, no score, 0-0. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Cyclone Cheer Squad, joined after homecoming by our outstanding middle school cheerleaders. Way to go, middle school cheer, and now welcome your Cyclone Varsity Cheer Squad. Way to go, Cyclone Cheer Squad! And now, ladies and gentlemen, tonight we want to celebrate a very special milestone and also a very special person. Miss Claudia Owens, can you please take the field? As many of you know, last month, Mrs. Claudia Owens worked her final game as the Cyclones athletic gatekeeper, a job she's performed wonderfully for 40 years. For most of us in the Porter Gowd community, we have no memory of ever coming to a sporting event without being greeted by her smile. In the last several weeks since her retirement, I've been asked dozens of times by everyone from Porter Gowd students and families to visiting coaches and fans, where's Miss Claudia? So we wanted to have her join us here at homecoming in front of one of the biggest crowds of the year and have a chance to officially bid her farewell. Miss Claudia's husband, Roy, one of the Cyclones' most loyal fans, and several members of her family are here tonight as well. Miss Claudia is joined on the field by head of school DeBose Eggleston, class of 93, and board chair Jim Buxton, class of 91. They're presenting her with flowers on behalf of the Porter Gowd Alumni Association. And we also have one other special presentation to make. The plaque being handed Miss Claudia now says, whereas Cyclone Athletics has always been a key component of the public image of Porter Gowd School, and whereas Mrs. Claudia Owens has, as gatekeeper, been the first person to greet every visitor to every Cyclone Athletic event for over 40 years, and whereas Miss Claudia has served in this role during the tenure of every head of school in the history of Porter Gowd, whereas Miss Claudia sold tickets to the first events ever held at John Singleton Field and the Wendell Center and has continued to do so until right now, whereas Miss Claudia has been an outstanding goodwill ambassador of the school for generations of Cyclones, and whereas Porter Gowd School is currently celebrating the 50th year anniversary of the matriculation of its first female students, and Miss Claudia is one of the most beloved women in school history, now, therefore, the Board of Trustees and Head of School do order that the ticket booth at John Singleton Field shall henceforth be named the Owens Ticket Booth in honor of Claudia Owens' faithful service to the school. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in thanking Miss Claudia from the bottom of our hearts, from all of us Cyclones. Thank you. And as if that wasn't big enough, now welcome to the homecoming course celebration for their 2022. Tonight we recognize six seniors nominated by their classmates for their leadership, their service, and for exhibiting the character that we most admire in a Cyclone. As I call your name alphabetically, please come out, be recognized. And when you're all out there together, we'll take a big picture and recognize our 2022 homecoming queen. Please welcome 2022 homecoming court, beginning with Kira Kelleher. The daughter of Caroline Kelleher and Kevin Kelleher, she's escorted by her brother, Brendan Kelleher. A member of the varsity track and field teams, Kira is also the head of environmental and animal service programs at Porter Gowd. Next, please welcome Pierce Lashley. Daughter of Brett Lashley and Kelly Lashley. She's escorted by both of her parents, Brett and Kelly. She's a four-year Porter Gowd lacrosse team member. She's service leader for coastal cleanup projects, a peer leader, and also a student tour guide. Next up, please welcome Dee Dee Lucas. The daughter of David Lucas, Nellon Lucas. She's escorted by her father, David. Dee Dee is a member of student council. She's one of our head service leaders. She is a peer leader, and she's captain of the girls' lacrosse team. Next, please welcome Alexis Manos. daughter of Teddy Manos and Tracy Manos. She's escorted by her dad, Teddy. Alexis is a four-year member of the volleyball team. She's a spirit leader, a service leader, and a peer leader. Now, please welcome Sarah Quinn. The daughter of Chris and Betsy Quinn. She is escorted by her dad, Chris Quinn. Sarah's work with Bicycles for Humanity raised $42,000, collected 2,500 bikes and 1,000 pairs of shoes. She works at Hedges Work Restaurant. She's a member of the Portergout Choir, Chamber Singers, and Portabellas. Acts in the Portergout musicals and is also a youth elder at John's Island Presbyterian Church. And finally, please welcome Jolene Temple. The daughter of Brad and Nicole Temple. She's escorted by her dad, Brad. She's team captain for the varsity tennis team. She's played on the soccer team for 2 years. Organized a drive for Low Country Orphan Relief. Is active in the play and is part of the computer science program. First of all, let's have a great big round of applause for these outstanding Cyclones, these young ladies who represent their class and their school so very well. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, please congratulate your 2022-23 Cyclone Homecoming Queen, Miss Sarah Quinn. And we're back. Second half action about to get underway. Cyclones to receive. Swamp Cats to kick off. Number 24, Bryson Wall, kicking off. Baker Lamberson fields the kick on the positive side of the 30, and the Cyclones will take over, first and 10. First and 10 Cyclone. Ball spotted at the 32-yard line. Hartley Bickerstaff on the carry. Bit gets five, makes second and five. Bickerstaff on the carry again. Gain of a yard or two, third and a longish three. Let's call it four. Ball pops out, Cyclones recover, but it'll bring up fourth down. Langenchevitz will come on to punt. Once again, number 11, Thomas Sumter will drop back to receive. Fair catch back at the 30-yard line. Booming punt by Chevis. And that's where the Swamp Cats will take over, first and 10. June hands off to Bryson Smith. Tony Brown wraps him up. 6 yard pickup on the play. Second and four. Yeah. Bryson Smith on the carry again. Breaks loose out down to the Cyclones 35. Cyclones 40. First and 10, Swampcats. Sumter on the carry down to the 20-yard line. Tyler June flush from the pocket. Escapes down inside the five. First and goal, Swampcats. Ball spotted at the 4-yard line. Sumter gets in the end zone, and the Swampcats draw first blood. Number 24, Bryson Watt, on to attempt the extra point. Kick is good, and so with 7:33 remaining in the third quarter, the Swampcats go up 7-0. Quarterback keeper Tony Brown out across midfield. Cyclone, first down. Scott Tibbles, the quarterback. Calls his own number and picks up 4 yards, second and six for the Cyclones. We have a Swamp Cat shaking up on the field. Bryce Manlow, the injured Swamp Cat, able to lead the field under his own power. Quarterback keeper for Scott Tibbles out across the 40-yard line. Third and one for the Cyclones. Tibbles on the carry. A lot of hankies on the field. We'll sort this one out. Personal foul on the Swamp Cats. Unsportsmanlike contact on the Cyclones. Or that conduct, I should say. That offsets. Result of the play is the first down. And after a lot of laundry, first and 10 Cyclones. Ball spotted at the 33-yard line. Quarterback keeper for Tibbles. Down inside the 10, flag down again. Penalty goes against the Cyclones. Ball will be spotted all the way back at the 25-yard line. Second and long. Settle on the carry. Wrestled down by number 10, Bryson Hodge. Third and long. Ladies and gentlemen, your Cyclone cheerleaders. Well done, cheer squad. Sorry for springing that one on you when you weren't ready. Third quarter action back underway. Less than four to play in the third. Cyclones third down and long. Pass is intercepted by Brandon King. And the Swamp Cats will get it back deep in their own territory, down near the 10-yard line. The Swamp Cats will take a timeout. Once again, please welcome your cheer squad. Bryson Smith, the ball carrier. Four yards for Smith. Second and six. And another flag on the field. This time it goes against the Swamp Cats. We'll back them up deeper. Ball spotted back at the 5 or 6 yard line. Second down. Second and about 15. All right, we'll just do that over again. No big deal. Replay second and 15. Pass goes out to number three, Jackson Brunson. Third down and two. Will Axel with the sack. And that brings up fourth down and seven. That'll bring on the Swampcats punt team. Number six, Noah Tanner, comes on to punt. John Settle drops back to receive. Is muffed and recovered by Lawrence Manning. First and 10 Swampcats from the 45. Smith on the carry. Go get 9 second and one. Ian Harris on the carry, tripped up. No gain on the play. Shea Sanderson, the one that got him, third and one. Quarterback sneak by Tyler June. Needed 6 inches, got a foot. First down. And that should be the last play of the third quarter with our score, Swampcats 7, Cyclones nothing. Once again, we want to welcome all of our alumni who made it back here for homecoming night. Especially want to welcome back those who are celebrating the 50th year of Women at Fort Gowd. Once again, we'd also like to remind you to celebrate with us our day four PG. You've got the tent set up with the alumni affairs, and you can pick up all the various souvenirs and goodies. But most importantly, please show your support for Fort Gowd. Yeah, make a post on social media with hashtag Day4PG wearing your garnet and gray. Show your belief in the Fort Gowd experience and what it means to you. goes Dallas, number 11, Thomas Sumter. Tackle for loss by Will Axon. Loss of two on the play. Second and 12. Sumter, the ball carrier. Plumcast space, third and five. Lane Bowen gets his number called. And he'll pick up the first down. Sumter on the carry again. Four-yard pickup, second and six. Bryson Smith on the carry. He'll get a couple, it'll be third and two. Sumter, the ball carrier. That brings up fourth down. Nope. They're going to call it a first down. Chains move, and the Swampcat offense stays on the field. Sumter on the carry again.
I started off doing something like that, and I have that
Another Swamp Cat first down. And that's a Swamp Cat touchdown. Bryson Watt on the kick. And his kick is good. So with 6:46 to play, Lawrence Manning goes on top, 14-0. Bryson Watt kicks off. Kick rolls dead exactly at the goal line. So the Cyclones will have a 99-yard field to deal with 6:44 to play. Tony Brown on the carry, gets out of the shadow of his own goalpost. He'll get 6, it'll be 2nd and 4. That's good enough to move the sticks. Cyclone first down. So gain on the play, second down. Staff on the carry. You'll get enough to move the chain. Cyclone first down. Dickerstaff tripped up at the line of scrimmage. Gain of a yard, second and nine. First pitch goes to settle. No gain. Make that a 1 yard gain, second and nine. Tony Brown on the keeper, gain of a yard, third down. Dickerstaff on the carry, gain of two. Got a swamp cat shaken up on the play. Nate Hawthorne shaking up Swamp Cat. Fourth down and 7 for the Cyclones. Tony Brown to Ryder Bishop. Cyclone, first down. And the Cyclones will take a timeout. Cyclones first and 10 at the 46-yard line. Pass goes out to number 5, Greer Height. He'll get out of bounds and stop the clock, 2nd and 5. Pass falls incomplete, 3rd down. Tony Brown to Ryder Bishop. Cyclone, first down. Pass falls incomplete. 2nd down. Pass falls incomplete. 3rd down, 3rd and 10. Thank you. Pass in for Hyatt, falls incomplete. That brings up fourth down for the Cyclones. One way to get the 15 yards you need. Flags come in. That's going to be a PI. Have a shaken up player on the field. Interference penalty will be 15 yards and a Cyclone first down. Ball spotted at the 15-yard line. Interception by number 6, Noah Tanner. So the Swampcats will get it back with 45 seconds to play. Thank you all for coming for this great homecoming night. We'd like to wish our guests from Lawrence Manning a very safe trip home. Cyclones are off this coming week for fall break. And we'll see you back here in 2 weeks for senior night as your Cyclones take on Cardinal Newman on the 21st.
Feeling is very mutual, guys. Don't tell these